Hello everyone. So today we are going to talk about chapter number 14, electric current and its effect. You know guys, there was a time when there were no electricity and most of the tasks were carried out manually. The invention of electricity brought a drastic change in our lives and it made the life easier by saving our labor as well as time. So here in this video, we are going to study about the electric current and its various effects. So in this video, we are going to study about electric current, electric circuits, components of electric circuits, types of electric circuits, and electrical symbols. So first of all, we should know about the electric current and how it is generated. You know, guys, before telling you the definition of electric current, I would like to give you a small explanation that how this electric charge or electric current is, you know, created. So you all know that the matter is made up of smaller substance which is called as atoms. Just like the buildings are made up of bricks, similarly all the matter is made up of smallest unit which is called as atoms. And atoms finally consist of three things, which are the electrons, protons and neutrons. So in this video we are not going into details of the structure of the atom. I just want to say that this electrons, specifically if I talk about the electron negatively charged particles, which are the electrons of the present in the atom, these are responsible for the creation of electric charge. When this electrons get transferred, the charge is created, and this flow of electric charge through a path is called as electric current. The flow of electricity through a path is called electric current. So there could be two definitions. Number one, the flow of electric charge through a path is called as electric current. Number two, the flow of electricity through a path is called as electric current. Now I would like to tell you that first ever source of continuous flow of electricity was a cell, which it was made by an Italian scientist named Alessandro Volta. There is a device with the help of which you can measure the amount of electric current flowing through a path, and that device is called as ammeter, and the SI unit for measuring the electric current is ampere. Now you know that electric current is also called as electrical energy. So as you know that energy can never be created nor be destroyed. It can only transfer from one form to another form. Similarly, when electric current passes through electric device, it produces electrical energy which can be further converted into other forms of energy. Here in this table there is three examples that I have quoted just to tell you that how electrical energy is converted into other forms through the electrical devices. So number one is electric bulb. Electric bulb uses electrical energy. We get the input of electrical energy, and what does it produce in result of that? It produces heat and light energy. Similarly, when we give electrical energy to the toaster, it gives us heat energy and it helps to toast the bread. And the next is the television. When we give electrical energy as an input to the television, it converts electrical energy into light and sound energy. These are the only three examples which is showing the conversion of electrical energy into other forms. There could be many more. You can just look around yourself and you can find. Next, we're going to talk about the electric circuit. Now, what is electric circuit? An electric circuit is a closed path along with which an electric current flows. It can also be defined as the continuous path made up of electric wire along which a current flow. In the diagram, you can see that how the electric current is flowing. You know, the cell, which is the source of electricity, is connected with the help of connecting wires to a device, which is the bulb here in this electric circuit. And there is also one switch which is responsible for the making or breaking of the electric circuit, or we can see that on and off of the bulb. When we on the switch, the bulb glows. Why? Because the source of electricity, which is cell, provides electrical energy and it flows through the connecting wire and reaches to the device. And that is the reason why the bulb glows. Okay. Now, we should know about the various components of the electric circuit. The electric circuit consists of the following components. Number one, a source of electricity. It could be a cell or a battery. Second, a device that uses the electric current. Here, generally, we take a bulb. In a normal daily life, we connect through electric, we connect like fans, ACs, etc. to the circuit. Another thing that we should have in the circuit is the connecting wires, because these connecting wires will be a path for the flow of current. Last but not the least, there should be an on and off switch or a key to make or break the circuit. And while we put on the switch or we on the key, the current flows because the path is complete. When we off the switch, the current do not flow, and this will result whether a device would work or not work in a circuit. Next, here are some symbols that we can use while drawing an electric circuit. You know, sometimes electric circuits have a large number of components. In such cases, to draw their true pictures is a tedious and a time-consuming job. Therefore, the components of electric circuit are represented by a specific symbols in the circuit diagrams, and these specific symbols are given here in the table. Here I am just quoted only six of the electrical component in this symbols. There are many more, but here this is the generally six symbols that you should know. First is electric cell, electric bulb, connecting wire. Connecting wire is generally represented by a straight line. Then a switch in on position. You can see here the connecting wires are connected, and two dots, the two bigger dots are connected with each other. Next is the switch in off position. Here you can see that the path is not continued, right? Two dots are not joined together. So this is the off position. Now battery of two cells. This is a symbol for the battery of two cells. Next, we should know about the open circuit. Now, what do you understand by the open circuit? A circuit with an open switch is called as open circuit. You can see in the diagram that the switch is not connected. Two red dots, they are not joined together. And the path is now incomplete. So, this is the open switch, and the circuit having the open switch is called as an open circuit. The current cannot flow through the circuit. Why? Because the path of electric current is incomplete. There is no joining in the red dots, which results in the incomplete path. So the current does not flow in an open circuit. Now the closed circuit. A circuit with a closed switch is known as closed circuit. You can see in the diagram that the two red dots are joined together. This result in the completion of the entire path. So the current always flows in a closed circuit because the path of electric current is completed. Next, what are the conditions for a current to flow? There are few conditions which are necessary for the current to flow. Number one, the electric circuit should be complete. That is, no part of the circuit such as wires or key or the switch should be broken. If they would be broken, the path will be incomplete, and with this result in the stoppage in the flow of the current. Next, the path should be closed. That is, the switch or the key should be in on position. Again, if the switch or the key is in the on position, the path is complete, and if the path is complete, the current will flow. When the switch or key is in off position, the path is incomplete and the current does not flow. Third, each part of the circuit should be a good conductor of electricity. What is a good conductor means? A good conductor means the materials which allow electricity to pass through them. So there should be a good conductor of electricity, okay? And the materials which do not allow electricity to pass through them, they are called as poor conductor of electricity, or we can say them insulators also. Next, we should know what is battery. So combination of two or more cells is called a battery. Cells we have already studied in class 6th, right? So here we will not study about the battery. When two or more cells are combined together, they make a battery. So in a battery, the positive terminal of one cell is always connected to the negative terminal of the next cell. This is the way we should connect a battery. If we connect positive terminal of one cell to the positive terminal of the another cell, this will result in the stoppage of electric current. Electric current will not flow at all. So in a battery, the positive terminal of one cell is always connected to the negative terminal of the next cell. Next, how are cells joined to make a battery? See, there are two ways by which you can join cells to form a battery. Now, first is, the cells can be placed one after another in a straight line so that the positive terminal of one cell connects to the negative terminal of the another cell. This you could see in the remote, you know, TV remote. You've seen that one cell is placed after another cell, just, you know, in a straight line. So this is the one way by which you can connect two cells in a battery. Another way of connecting two cells in a battery is that the cells can be placed side by side. In this case also, the positive terminal of one cell is joined with the negative terminal of another cell. You can see in this diagram that with the help of the connecting wire, the positive terminal of one cell is connected to the negative terminal of another cell. See? Okay. In this video, we have studied about the open circuit, closed circuit, components of electric circuits, what is electric current, everything, right? This is just an introduction. In the next video, we are going to study about the heating effects and the magnetic effect of electric current. Till then, revise this, and thank you so much for watching the video.